obviously clicked this video to find out how to go viral on TikTok. So with no BS, let's talk about it. What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to Creative Spark. If you're new here, we're all about helping digital entrepreneurs and social media savvies here. So if you're one of them, smash the subscribe button for me and hit the like button as well. It might be the only free way that you can actually help changing someone else's life. But let's talk about TikTok and why you're not growing. I'm assuming that's why you're here, right? That or you must have really liked my shirt or my hat. Can't really help it. The link below for just for the merch. But jokes aside, guys, why do you think you're having a hard time to getting followers or just getting views? So you must be doing all the cliche stuff. I'm assuming that all the Instagram or YouTube gurus are saying about TikTok, right? Posting consistently, giving your own spin off the trends and being patient and all that good stuff. Oh, you're still not growing? I guess it's the time to learn about what makes people watch things and what makes TikTok feature your videos. So the first thing I'm gonna recommend you do is use words that will trigger people to comment, whether positive or negative. It's totally up to you. Like, negative comments still counts. A lot of people are gonna criticize me because I'm saying this, but remember the hierarchy. Shares, comments, then likes. Like, so likes are really not that important. Like, you gotta focus on comment and getting a lot of people share your content. So this is basically a clean call to action, but you can also trigger people in different ways. Like, here's a real fact. When people really like something, they just take the entertainment and walk away. But like, rarely anyone feels the need of commenting about anything that's super good. Like, when people don't like something or they get triggered by it, like, you can be sure that they're gonna comment about it and they're gonna be sharing with a lot of other people that they know because they just got triggered. They just wanna post it so bad. So it's totally up to you whether you wanna play positive, negative, or naughty if you want. Like, you need to use text, titles, and at least like something that will trigger people to comment on your videos. So the best usage I've ever seen this technique was a TikTok page about ice cream. Yes, it's just about ice cream, where the person in the store makes the ice cream and it's basically just about it. But he adds a lot of voiceovers with a super cringy stories and deep gossip narrative that really gets thousands of people comment about the stories every single time. Nobody cares about the ice cream. The page is about ice cream, but it gets just get thousands of comments about the stories that this guy has been telling. It's whether a gossip or it's just something funny. Like, those are the things that get people comment. But also people comment down when they're really jealous of something, feeling attracted to someone, or offended by many things. Like, keep these in mind because, like, your great content, it might be great, but standalone being amazing content, it may not be enough to do well on TikTok. Let's talk about the second thing. Second thing I wanna talk about is the R word. You gotta create relevant content in your niche, like relevant, not trendy. Staying in the relevant is much more important than posting daily, by the way. If your content is relevant and relatable, that's definitely gonna do well. Like, one example is in my creative niche, for example, whenever people talk about the general terms like how to take better photos, it definitely does well, not gonna lie. But well, when they actually talk about things like new iPhone 13 versus $5,000 Sony camera, they happen to get like 10 times more attention and a lot more views because, you know, things they talk about, they're specific, very relevant, and it's they're like really hot topics they're in their time. Basically, everyone will be hyped in the next 1 or 2 weeks about iPhone 13 when it just comes out. And this is one of the reasons topics like finance, stock market, or news cycles, these are doing incredibly well regardless of the content quality, whether it's great or poor quality, because with these type of content, they are daily, highly relevant, and people are researching these things every single day because they need every type of information. They gotta track those things every single day. And my last tip for any video to go viral is shifting the focus more on the action or the object rather than the person to be shareable. So you gotta be shareable in this. Like, if you're a personality brand or personal brand, need to be a face of every single content you make. This more probably won't apply to you, but other than that, for any other type of content, if you make the focus about the action, object, or location, basically independent from the people, like, it becomes universal and relevant and shareable. Like, basically you remove the fact of unconscious discrimination from anyone. Like, your content becomes universal and shareable. Like, basic tutorial that doesn't require any language skills, like, that doesn't include any talk, like, it just doesn't require me to know something to understand it. And it doesn't include any person who maybe I don't want to share because of I didn't like that person. I don't know. Like, so my recommendation is if you're not a public figure, give this idea a try. If you're not a celebrity, just try this and do videos without your voice and your presence. You will see a much bigger level of engagement and a lot more shares and views in your video. Possibly it is gonna make a lot more for you pages in the TikTok. So if you look at the internet, you'll see most famous videos. There are the funny ones who you don't even know the people who are shooting these videos, and they become quickly memes over the years. And also there are videos you learn something new, like cleaning tutorials or cooking tutorials. It's just about the food. It's just about the action there you're learning. So it's not about the person there. So you don't care about the person. You don't care about where they live. So it's just a universal content everybody would like to share because it's teaching or it's making you laugh. So most of the tutorials like have fully focused on the products rather than any storyteller, as I said. So guys, don't forget, on the internet, two things really make money. Like one, if you can really make people laugh, like super hard. Like, and the two, if you really can teach people something new, they would like to share these things with their friends because they're both relatable and shareable now. So let me know if you ever created these kind of contents in the past and on TikTok specifically, and comment it down how well they did. All right, you know what? I'm gonna end it right here, guys. I hope you enjoyed this week's video. That was really short and on point without any BS. Usually I talk about how to build a strong audience in social media, but today it was actually only about going viral, becoming the next hit on the internet, on TikTok specifically. So if you really enjoyed this kind of quick content, please do me a favor and hit the thumbs up button right there and smash the subscribe for the next videos if you wanna join me in the studio. Also, you can always find me on the internet as Be The Creator on TikTok and Instagram. And as always, guys, till I see you next time in the next video, go out and be the creator that you want to show the world. That's it. I'm out. Peace.